Okay, nice way to begin our video, and we'll try this again because it was striked for some reason due to copyrights, and I couldn't understand what it was, but whatever it is, because I played music for like 20 seconds for fair use, but YouTube's crazy, but I love them. So maybe we'll make money off YouTube. So what we're doing is we're showing how to drain a water heater properly. It's a maintenance that should be done twice a year, at least once a year, to maintain your tank electric water heater. I don't know how it works with gas. I guess it works differently and you don't have to do that. Maybe just like let off the gas and steam. But, or maybe you do have to drain it that way. But tankless water heaters, you don't have to do this with. So, but I've heard from all people that, you know, plumbers and electricians, you don't want a tankless water heater. So maybe because they make more money with that, but honestly, no. So you go to your circuit breaker, which I have here. So I see AC up and down. First is the range. The second two are the water heaters, these green bad boys there and there. And then this is for the dryer. Now, if you're uncertain and you don't have a list and everything, or it's faded away and you want to make sure, just flip above what you think it is, one, and below what you think it is, and then flip the ones that it is, and you can't go wrong there. Remember, just shutting off your power is a temporary delay in, you know, the and disruption of the power of your house, but it's not going to do anything damage-wise, because that's why we have a circuit breaker. Anyway, going outside to show you not what to do when you're draining a water heater. Here's my water main here, right here. You don't shut that off. Okay. What you do is, once you shut off the electricity, you go upstairs to your bathrooms and also downstairs, because I have two water heaters. Well, downstairs ones that cover the kitchen and the laundry room and the two bathrooms downstairs, and the rest cover the upstairs bathrooms. So you wanna turn on the water like this. And since I don't have it, I did it yesterday, so this is all like post facto. Turn it on, push to hot, and let it sit for a little while. Then the next thing you're going to do is you're going to go into wherever you have your water heaters, your laundry room, your utility room, your garage, little nook and hiding space or something like that. Well, I have them in my garage here. So here's what you do. Don't be fooled by this box that it's something for the power. It's just a timer box and everything with the water heater. It's only connected to the upstairs water heater. This is the downstairs water heater. Rheem water heaters, I believe they're either 40 or 52 gallon. They're great water heaters. They have lasted over 20 years and are still functioning good based on my maintenance and whatnot. So you're going to go over to these valves, both these, and you're going to turn them counterclockwise, like a couple of turns. You'll hear water kind of flowing. You don't need to worry about this gap, this release gap, because you're releasing the pressure by turning on the faucets inside, getting that water hot and everything, so it gets hot. And then when you go to drain, you're going to drain. So you attach a garden hose here, right at the bottom here. It's like a little spigot. So you take a garden hose, you attach it to that. And some have actual knobs or valves. This one doesn't, neither does this one. So you just take a flathead screwdriver and you turn it counterclockwise all the way. And then you run your garden hose into your waistline, into the grass. Like I just bought a 100-foot garden hose at Costco, a regular rubber one. Trusty, it's always good to have for $27, and that's a pretty good deal. And everything, because everywhere I looked at Walmart and Target and Lowe's and Home Depot, they were all over 30, 35, 40, 50 bucks and everything. And this is just my other hose. I have two of the metal non-kink hoses, the 50-foot ones that are great for the backyard, but they're also kind of stuck to my spigot. They won't turn even with a wrench, so basically they're permanent fixtures there. But it's fine because that's what I need them there and that's what they're used for. So anyway, so this is basically what you do. When you when you turn that valve, and you can even do it after you attach the garden hose and turn the valve, water's gonna drain. It's gonna come right out. You hear like a ee, like a hissing, like warning water noise, and it's gonna drain right out the hose. Now you want to do it for a good 10 to 15 minutes to get that out, a 40-gallon or 52-gallon water heater. You'll get that out. It's going to get all the calcium deposits, the sediments, any rust, any bad stuff in there, and then you're just going to have fresh water coming into the tank through, when you take care of it. Now, don't worry about these things, these blue things. Those are access panels for the electricity. I learned the hard way when I shut the timer off and not the actual power off that there are live wires still in there, and yeah, got a little bit of a jolt, so silly me. Anyway, a plumber could do this for you, or a professional could do it for you, but it's so easy to do, and it's really, really important for the water heater's maintenance. So to reverse that, what we would do is after 10, 15 minutes of draining, and it's still going to drain a little bit, it's got flowing thing, water coming through it. It's just flushing out the waste at the bottom. So after 10 or 15 minutes of doing this, you want to go back in. You want to go over here where the water hose is connected, where the hose is connected, and then you want to turn clockwise to shut it off. And then you want to turn your valve all the way clockwise on both of the water heater valves on top and everything. You see those that you want to turn back. And then basically you just follow the footsteps back and you. Oh, also one thing, when you turn the faucets on and they're running, and then you turn the power off and you're draining the water heater and it's sipping out, like drizzling out, you could turn those faucets off. You really don't need them on. So you go in and then you flip the circuit breakers, get their power back on the water heaters, and then open up the line, the pressure valve, as far as for and go in the sink, the laundry room, wherever, and put on the hot water, and you'll hear like hiss, and that's just equalizing pressure. And then your water will get hot again, and then you did it right. So that's how you successfully drain a water heater. Do it twice a